It was not Mossad at my apartment.
Why not?
Because even if they were operating without my knowledge and going after you, they would have gotten me out safely first. Even the head of Mossad would not sacrifice one of our own to serve as a foreign power. Nobody is that good a friend to us.
But that fighting technique is taught by Mossad, and we are the only ones from outside to receive that training.
And how do you know that? You mean Elliot might kill you, but he would never lie to you? Don't you see? The men you've described as Mossad operatives also fit the same description as you. Kisses and the years just roll away. You think I'm that easy, Solly?
Wicked smile. What are you thinking?
Just wondering.
Wondering what?
What is gonna be left for us to do on our honeymoon?
I don't know. But if life gets any better, it'll probably kill me.
Oh, you'd survive. And in about 20 years, you'll probably be bored with me.
I doubt that. No.
Yes. Erica? Baru, Anibadar. Got to report in.
What, do you have a drill now?
I'll be back as soon as I can.
Oh, no. Don't keep me waiting too long, huh? You know, my love may not last. You know, my love may not last. You know, my love may not last.
The October War,
poetic title. The Israeli tactical execution was superb. Did their little war interrupt your romance?
It's not a fling, Elliot. I want to marry her.
Impossible.
Why impossible? A lot of agents are married.
Not on your level. For people like us, relationships are always shadowed by the possibility of betrayal.
Are you saying there are no operatives on my level who are married?
I'm saying there are no operatives on your level, period. Except Chris.
You two are unique. A wife would be a constant target for coercion to force you into an act of betrayal. Women are wonderful, charming companions, and the best sexual release ever devised. But for us, nothing more. Saul, you're like a samurai sword. You've been hammered and honed for years to cut through bone and steel. You don't use it to slice bread.
You don't use it to slice bread. You don't use it to slice bread.
What are you thinking?
Lots of things.
Such as?
Such as bone and steel.
Bone and steel.
Elliot never wanted you to matter in my life. He said you would compromise me.
And?
He was probably right.
Cobritz.
Yes.
Blue Star.
Sarah. Scrambler's activated.
I have reason to
believe Romulus and Remus are being set up by Elliot. Somehow he's trying to implicate us in the Partigan business. Give me a few days slack.
Courier delivery?
Use Route 11. Okay. Ready for Mama's shopping list?
They know, and we know they know, and...
Do you mind? So, if we spot them, we terminate, no matter where they are.
Well, I would avoid doing it near a policeman. Very nasty prisons here. That one's ours. That's 18 people so far carrying something.
He's too well dressed to be a courier, so he must be the courier.
Il vient d'acheter 3 dozen grammes de pronoms. Il n'est posé de contact.
passports, IDs, driver's licenses, credit cards. $50,000.
What's that?
Computer printout. Elliot said you were the only ones he sent to Israel. I had the Mossad computer to run a little check. It's a list of all operatives Elliot sent for special Mossad training. 18 men.
18?
I don't believe it.
Look, all these others went to Israel after us.
And they were sent in pairs, like us.
Two lieutenants, two sergeants, two petty officers.
Each pair is from the same hometown.
Maybe there's a common denominator connecting the towns. Philadelphia, Akron, Omaha, Shade Gap. Ring any bells?
Chris, look at this. Philadelphia Franklin School for Boys. Omaha Boys School. Akron Union City Boys Academy. Shade Gap Institute.
Military schools?
Orphanages. These guys are all orphans. Like us.
Elliot would find pairs of kids in institutions, encourage them to bond as blood brothers, and then he'd play the surrogate father to all of them.
We were just part of some damn program. Elliot deceived us from day one. He used us.
When did you first meet him?
We saw him talking to Colonel Nesbitt. They seemed to be good friends. I guess he'd been watching us for days, probably looking for two kids that already formed a bond.
He began to visit us once a week, and he'd give us these damn baby Ruth bars.
He was the only one who ever showed us any kindness. You can't imagine what it was like to have someone like him as your father when the others had nobody.
We were apprenticed to two martial arts masters, Sensei Ishii and Sensei Kim.
We were taught martial arts and discipline, and the Bushido code of the samurai, the vow the warrior takes to obey his shogun for life.
Five times daily, we were to repeat the phrase, "A samurai without a shogun is a wanderer. Elliot is our shogun."
We studied under them 4 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Weren't you allowed to do what other boys do? What about girls?
No girls. Recreation was movies at the school.
Even when Elliot took us to the movies, it was war, spy movies. But no girls. In our training, girls are only for sexual release.
Oh, wonderful. How did you get into the CIA?
It was after we finished case officer training at Langley, we joined Elliot's Special Operations Unit.
We were kept away from the mainstream operatives. I think we can assume that's also what happened with these other guys.
Elliot's own little army. Does the CIA know what he's doing?
Probably only what he wants them to know.
Nobody's that powerful.
Erica, Elliot has been in the CIA longer than anyone else.
He has people and entire systems that report only to him. Even the director leaves him pretty much alone.
I don't care how powerful Elliot is. Somebody else has to know what he's doing. He can't shut down information to everyone.
Elliot once said, to really find out about a man, talk to his enemies. Chris, who hates Elliot more than anybody you know?
All clear.
Come, look, guy. I gotta help.
It's vermouth. Sweet and dry mixed.
That won't help.
It's enough to take the edge off and still keep you sober. We need you sober, Hardy.
Oh. Where'd you guys learn this torture? Cambodia?
Sorry to play rough. Elliot's been ahead of us all the way.
Elliot? Think I'd help Elliot? 28 years, the bastard got me fired. I defected to Beth first. Well, why is Elliot after you guys?
That's what we're trying to find out.
We want Elliot. To get him, we need whatever you got on him.
What then?
He's terminated with extreme prejudice.
I'll drink to that.
Boat coming. Clear.
So on day one, Elliot and I were rivals. Elliot eventually became head of counterintelligence. I was section head of positive intelligence. I was a Boston Irish slum kid competing against Elliot, the Silver Spoon orphan from Virginia.
Elliot is an orphan?
You didn't know? I thought that's why he took a shine to you two. Elliot's parents died when he was 5 years old. He was left plenty of money, and he was raised by a wealthy friend of his father's, Tex Otten, one of the founders of the Abelard Sanction. He was OSS and CIA, and he brought Elliot in. It's a real family affair. So from day one, we were in competition, and I gave him one hell of a fight. I was beginning to discover some bad things about him. That's why he got me dumped.
What do you mean you discovered bad things about him?
Found out how he always gave himself an edge.
How?
He kept the best dirty files on anybody who could be a threat or of use to him. Presidents, cabinet members, heads of the agency. He had them all. Sex, drugs, tax evasion. When Elliot needed anything or he felt threatened, he simply showed them their file. Problem solved.
Why were you investigating him?
Since the 50s, whenever anything went wrong with an operation, Elliot always yelled that there was a mole in the agency, and especially on big screw-ups like the Bay of Pigs. He had everybody so busy looking for the mole that we never got any work done. It was a damn good way to paralyze operations, which is exactly what a real mole would do.
You think Elliot is a mole?
Well, he ain't kosher. Try and follow this. Tex Otten brought his stepson, Elliot, into the CIA. Lord Landish brought his son into MI6. Both fathers were founders of the Abelard Sanction. Sir Percival Landish, Elliot's British counterpart at MI6, is known to have very good liaison with the Soviets. So, Elliot could be the mole, Landish the courier.
You have any proof?
If I did, I'd be dead. But whatever Elliot's got going, it's somehow tied to Landish at MI6. You wanted dirt on Elliot. What I just told you was enough to get me fired.
Sir Percival Landish.
Excuse me, do you know where we can get some decent roast beef in London?
Beef's good, Lox is lousy.
He's ours.
Welcome to London, Colonel. We've got the special equipment you ordered, also a very isolated location.
Let's go.
Being followed.
We better be. That's my security team.
Hey,
good hunting.
Hello, Hardy. I didn't realize your diet included solids. You recently had two visitors. Where did they go?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Only one guard at the gate. You're not gonna believe this. Sir Percival Landish is puttering with those damn roses just like Elliot.
What about inside?
He's talking to somebody. Could be a bodyguard. He's leaving. Headed towards the house.
Shouldn't there be more guards?
Maybe Elliot's ahead of us, warned Landish. Could be a setup.
This is England. They probably wouldn't have more than one guard on him at night. He's only a deputy director.
Now, how would I know to come to you? Because Saul and Chris were both taught to think like their enemy. Naturally, they would contact their enemy's enemy to try to get information. All I had to do was to run down my list of enemies to decide whom to contact.
That must have taken you forever.
You were near the bottom of the list. Almost an afterthought.
I'm crushed. Now say again who was supposed to have visited me?
Saul and Chris.
Oh. What's news with Saul and Chris?
Good response, Hardy. Always answer a question with a question. Chris violated the Abelard sanction.
Yeah? So naturally the first thing they do is go get a lush to help them. Smart. I'd be a lot of help against the Russians.
Sloppy, Hardy. Very sloppy. Never give information to an interrogator, no matter how irrelevant. You mentioned the Russians. You couldn't have known that the Russians claimed the Abelard violation unless Saul or Chris told you.
So I'm out of practice. You want to torture me. But don't you lecture me. That's too cruel.
I want to know what you told them and where they've gone.
Okay. You don't need the chemicals. Let's talk.
We have to use them anyway, Hardy. You know the drill.
Oh, hell. What does it matter? Look. Saul and Chris came to see me. We talked. I told them things about you. I know where they are. Can we make a deal?
No. But after we talk, I promise to make your death as pleasant as possible. Alcohol poisoning.
What a guy.
Good evening, Mr. Landish.
I believe you have the advantage of me.
Good. It's about time I have advantage over somebody. If you call your bodyguard in, he's dead.
What do you want?
Answers. And we're only going to ask once.
We?
We is me and my gauche friend over here. I'm the nice guy. There's no telling what he'll do.
Put that down.
That's the dwarf yellow princess, isn't it? It's very rare.
What'd I tell you?
Imbecile! prose took 5 years to create.
Oh, yum. Oh, what an exquisite teardrop. Oh, and look at this luscious Aphrodite.
Kid knows his roses, huh? He had a great teacher.
Please, the teardrop. What do you want to know?
Elliot.
Elliot? What about him?
He's a mole. You're his courier.
That's absurd. My God. My God, stop.
Elliot.
I delivered messages, yes, several years ago, between Elliot and the KGB, but that doesn't make Elliot a mole.
What was in the messages?
I never read them. Elliot said later that one message contained information about a KGB spy in the CIA. Oh, good Lord, man, you could ask the KGB courier himself. He's in Paris.
What's his name? What's he doing? Stop wasting my time.
He's Victor Kotcherby, the concert violinist.
Didn't he defect from Russia a few years ago?
The Kotcherby defection was a sham. He's been KGB from the start. The free world bought the story, and Kotcherby has a brilliant cover.
Not enough. Go on.
Kotcherby passed the messages to me for Elliot. You could go to Paris and persuade him to tell you.
Okay. You're coming with us.
What?
Going over the wall.
With my arthritis, my brittle bones would break like matchsticks. I'm afraid my poor physical condition has created an impasse.
Really? Elliot says an impasse is merely a pause between ideas. He's full of sayings like that. We'll just have to get creative.
I win. Two out of three. You stay with Landish, I go to Paris with Erica.
Let's make it 4 out of 7.
Oh, no way. We agreed. Loser babysits Landish. It's the tougher job. You might die of boredom. Look, Erica and I should be in Paris by noon. A Mossad contact should have located Kotcherby. With any luck, we'll get him tonight. We'll find out what he knows and how that leads to Elliot.
What happens after Elliot?
I don't know. But I'm glad you're thinking about a future.
Saul, I couldn't live with my conscience anymore and still serve Elliot. I'm sorry if I failed you.
You never failed me. And as for Elliot, he may have manipulated most of our lives, but he could never come between us.
Well, maybe after Elliot, the other ghosts will be gone too. That is, if you don't mess up in Paris.
I don't intend to.
Food's great, and women even better. Your friends are very helpful. Party's tonight.
Well, call me afterwards. And be careful.
Don't be such a nudge.
Section, well done. I had absolutely no confidence that an interface would work.
He's mine!
You're absolutely certain he's dead?
I personally viewed the body. We're claiming the killer's an Abelard sanctioned termination. Your barbarian destroyed my yellow princess and a priceless teardrop. Blushing Aphrodite was the only one of its kind. Years of work, he'd have destroyed them all.
The body?
Flown out to sea, weighted and dropped. Elliot, you must inform the KGB that Romulus and the Israeli woman are going after Kotchubey in Paris.
Yes. Yes, I'll do that.
You sound strange, Elliot.
It's nothing. I'll inform you when I hear. So it's finally done. After all these years, I didn't think it would affect me like this.
Do you still want Romulus dead?
Yes. No matter how I personally feel, Romulus must be killed or everything is ruined. It's ironic. Saul and Chris, they were the first. And they've survived all the others, except Castor and Pollux. There's a Chinese saying, the greatest curse of the gods is to survive your own children.
Smile as if you've just accepted an invitation from me. Then come with me around the corner and get in the car.
I trust you've had a good sleep, Romulus. It's 6 a.m. The drug leaves a licorice aftertaste and a remarkable headache.
Coffee helps. If you don't usually drink coffee, you'll find that now is the perfect time to start. Allow me to introduce myself.
That's unnecessary. You're Colonel Boris Orlik, Paris Section Chief KGB. Probably the best intelligence theoretician in Europe. Anyone who doesn't know who you are, Colonel, would be sent back to the mailroom.
I'm flattered.
False modesty. Erica.
Down the hall. And recovering faster than you. Women normally do with this drug. Something to do with estrogen.
You were in a private sanatorium about 2 hours outside Paris.
It's run by the KGB and is completely legit, as you say. It's something of an embarrassment to us since it annually returns a substantial profit of capitalistic proportion.
Okay, Colonel. You've removed my shackles, offered me sustenance, and indicated my location. Not the usual routine for a KGB interrogation, is it?
I'm afraid drugs have radically changed the art, Romulus. Besides, this isn't an interrogation.
What is it?
Well, that depends. Shall we discuss it like two professionals? After all, I could have easily killed you at any time. Croissant? Care to guess how we knew you were after Kotchubey?
Ouija board.
Elliot. He called me.
Naturally. Elliot is a mole.
Elliot a mole? Don't we wish. Elliot is one of the few geniuses that intelligence has produced.
if you'll pardon the pun. Witness the program that developed you and Remus.
You know about the orphans?
My dear fellow, the system is so brilliant it's been adopted by others. It's been named after him. The Elliot Paternal Matrix.
What others?
I thought you'd figured it all out, and that's why you kidnapped Landish.
No. We're trying to get Elliot before he kills us. Landish is the key.
Let's take a walk.
Dobry dzień.
Dobry dzień. Listen carefully. I want Elliot dead as badly as you do.
But you said the KGB wanted him alive.
The KGB doesn't understand what's going on any more than the CIA. I know that there is a conspiracy within Abelard. It's taken me years to put it together.
The conspiracy involves five members of the Abelard Sanction, led by Elliot of CIA, Landish of MI6, my own superior, Anton Kovshuk, who was Elliot's counterpart at KGB. The others are Beck of West Germany and de Gilles of France.
What is this conspiracy?
Those men have all shifted their allegiances to Abelard first and their country second.
Why?
Power and control. After World War II, the conspirators took it upon themselves to maintain the balance of power. Each would watchdog his own government. They would trade information and even sabotage their own government's operations, if necessary. And they did.
Examples, your own U2 incident. The Bay of Pigs, Great Britain's Suez Crisis, our invasion of Hungary, and the Berlin Wall. The US was tipped off to both of our operations days ahead of time. Those were the big ones. There were hundreds of others.
How can just five conspirators do all this?
With a small group of special operatives who can be pulled off their routine assignments and do whatever they are told. They answer only to their boss and ask no questions.
The orphans.
Trained in the Elliot Matrix since childhood to obey their fathers without question.
Oh, God. Like destroying the Partigan Foundation.
Yes. The Partigan plan would have upset the Middle East balance of power. So Elliot destroyed Partigan.
But why kill me afterwards? I was still loyal to Elliot.
You could have revealed that Elliot gave the order, which could expose the conspiracy. With you dead, Israel could be blamed. You were expendable. All the orphans are. You have to be for the system to work.
What do you want?
I want the conspirators dead and the conspiracy destroyed.
Why?
Simple.
These men are betraying their own countries in order to play God.
So you want me to kill them, hmm? All five. And in the process, protect you, right?
Exactly. You are already a marked man, and I mustn't be blamed. Remember, my immediate superior is one of the conspirators.
No. My fight is with Elliot, period.
You're wrong. Landish told Elliot you were coming to Paris after Kotcheby.
Chris is dead. Landish had him shot.
You're lying. You don't even know where he is.
In England, near a lighthouse in Cornwall.
That's impossible. No.
One of Landish's special assault teams. Orphans molded in the Elliot Matrix.
No.
I have a man in MI6
no.
near Landish.
No.
Landish insisted on seeing Chris's body. It was nearly cut in half by an Uzi at close range.
No. 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 I'll kill him.
That bastard stole our lives. Fool Chris, I'll kill him. God, I'll kill him. I haven't cried since I was 5.
That makes these tears very precious.
Our agreement was 15 minutes. Your decision?
You have a deal.
You'll kill all 5. Landish first, Elliot last. As I locate the others, I'll feed the information to you. You're about to make a most spectacular escape. One of my most trusted men will be guarding the south entrance, end of the hall. He will be deliberately lax. Don't kill him.
What about Erica?
Obviously, she stays as my insurance. One of you escaping would be phenomenal. Both would be miraculous. The Kremlin does not believe in miracles.
How do I know I can trust you?
When all 5 conspirators are dead, she goes free. You have my word as one professional to another. The road in front leads to Paris. There's a blue Citroën parked 10 kilometers south. Don't kill any of my men.
Saul.
That's all I said? Call if you hear anything more. That was a personal message to you, sent from Kavshuk in Moscow. Apparently he's in a rage.
Go on.
Romulus escaped.
Saul escaped? How many did he kill?
None.
Is the woman dead?
No, they're questioning her to find out where he's gone.
A killing machine like Saul escapes and nobody's dead? No. That's wrong. That's all wrong.
Apparently they wanted to question him first.
They're lying. Someone let him go.
But why?
To get me, obviously. Like Saul, somebody in the KGB found out what it's all about. Why can't that blockhead Kovshuk see it?
But maybe the KGB has simply turned Saul.
Impossible. Not one of the orphans has ever turned. The only deal they can offer him is freedom to get me. When you know Saul, that's simple. The woman is probably a hostage. By now, Saul has found out that Landish killed Chris. He'll come after Landish and me. Question is, which one first? Landish, to make me sweat. We'll lay a trap through Landish while we prepare the defensive ground if he comes after me. Get me Landish. We'll see how Romulus does against MI6.
Fish and chips?
Why the bloody hell did we have to meet face to face?
Bloody hell? Where did you learn English? British war movies?
Cambridge. Well, get on with it. I catch the hovercraft back to France in an hour.
I have to talk about this face to face because I can't trust your damn telephones. How's Erica?
Fine. I shall see her at the sanatorium tonight. Well, what do you want?
The order of kills won't work. You want me to go after Landish, then beg to Gilles Kovshuk and finally Elliot. I want Elliot immediately after I get Landish.
Why?
The odds. If something happens to me going down that order, Elliot would go free.
And if you get Elliot, you'll forget about the others.
I can't because you still hold Erica. And this deal is pointless if I don't get Elliot.
No. You kill Landish, then the others. And Elliot comes last.
Listen to
last.
Me. Listen to me very carefully. I'm getting Elliot immediately after Landish, no matter how long it takes me to find him. If in the meantime any harm comes to Erica, I'll come after you. And before God, I'll get you. I'm very comfortable in Russia. Now, this is your choice. Give me Elliot's location and trust me, or deal with me as an enemy.
You're completely mad. And you think like a Russian.
Only when I'm up against one.
The Abelard's secret retirement retreat in New Zealand recently welcomed a very distinguished American guest.
Thank you. By the way, I'm taking Landish today.
Today? You couldn't possibly be ready.
It's Graham in Washington.
Find out what he wants.
He can't be disturbed. Any message? Landish is dead.
How?
Explosion in his greenhouse.
Remarkable. Landish and his roses. By heaven, that Romulus has style. We're ready.
There isn't time. Kovchuk has arrived from Moscow. There's a gray sedan outside the front door. If you get to Romulus, tell him... tell him we're even.
Go prepare the girl for execution.
Comrade Kovchuk, I had no idea you were coming.
You let the American go. We both know why.
Where did you hear such a...
Denial adds further insult. Obviously, you planned for Romulus to kill me and Elliot and so on. I want to know where the American has gone.
But I don't know what...
Thank you.
Pollux, please give me a status reading from the snipers, will you?
Status report?
Just waiting for someone to kill, Chief.
Number 2 negative.
Number 3 negative. Number 4 negative.
You know, Elliot, it is possible Romulus doesn't know where you are. It's been 6 weeks.
He knows.
Excuse me, Elliot. I must speak with you.
Yes, Felix.
If your target gets inside the fence, he has sanctuary. Should your snipers shoot him then, they would be in sanctuary violation. And you will be immediately terminated by an Abelard security team. House rules.
I understand. And thank you for your concern. Oh, and by the way, my compliments to the chef. The veal last night was superb.
Jacques. He used to teach at the Cordon Bleu, Paris.
Caution the men. Romulus must not get to the fence.
He won't. These guys are the best. All units, talk to me. Don't lose your edge now. Romulus is very good.
Number 3. Calling my shot, left eye. $500.
You're on. This is number 4, and I'm blood hungry. Target's on the road.
Romulus, sanctuary.
This is not your usual Abelard safe house. This is the Abelard Retreat.
It's expensive.
Gold certificates. About $200,000.
That'll buy 6 months.
I won't be here that long.
That brings us to the most important rule, the sanction. I know you're here to get Elliot, or he you. If either of you violate the sanction by killing inside this retreat, you will be instantly terminated.
We are 100 acres encircled by state-of-the-art security. There's horseback riding, fishing, swimming, skiing, anything that you want, all safe within our retreat. Security patrols constantly, and they're hand-picked from all of the intelligence services.
I'm impressed.
You will be if you cross them. The clientele is composed of refugees from intelligence operations everywhere. There is more behind-the-scenes history here than any other spot in the world. Look. See the guy with the beard over there? He's Egyptian. Big shot in Sadat's counterintelligence. Fled here when Sadat was assassinated. His chess opponent was an Israeli hitman against the PLO. There are no politics here. Whatever they want, they can get. Drugs, sex, food. There are no secrets here.
Yeah.
would just nail him.
You kill him here, you violate the sanctions. They'll hunt you down and they'll terminate me for giving the orders. My plan was to lure him here and to kill him before he got inside. Now we're both stalemated.
May I suggest the table in the corner?
That one's fine. Something I said?
What you did last night was very naughty. Fishing is the only love a man can count on. Remember? I taught you and Chris everything I know about it.
Yeah, I remember.
So, you got inside. Congratulations. Now we just stare each other to death?
Chris and I wanted to find you and hear why you betrayed us. He can't do that now.
You can't begin to understand the agony of that kind of decision. Sacrificing someone you love to a greater cause.
Tell me something. What cause is so great it justifies taking 18 orphaned kids and turning them into some kind of killer robots?
So you found out?
Oh, yeah. After all, I had a fanatic for a teacher.
Oh, you weren't the first. I was. Tex Orton was my surrogate father.
Yeah, I know all about that, too. Let's just skip to this grand idea we've all been sacrificed for, the Abelard conspiracy.
Conspiracy? Ridiculous. It's an attempt to prevent the incompetent politicians from destroying us all. Saul, have you any idea how stupid, petty, dangerous politicians can be?
I don't want your political theories, Elliot. Just give me the reasons.
This is cold reality, Solly. The reality of idiotic decisions by politicians that cost thousands of lives and billions of dollars.
Are you telling me we were all sacrificed because you don't trust the duly elected?
Yes. I've seen the superpowers undermine foreign governments in the name of national security. The real reason is a clash between big business and socialism. Very simply, this conspiracy, as you call it, holds the politicians in check so that no country has too big an edge or is too successful. I know I've done right, Saul.
When you had me blow up Hartigan, you had me kill 5 businessmen. Those weren't soldiers, they weren't assassins. 5 ordinary businessmen, for God's sake. All this Hartigan mess because you thought you could maintain the status quo in the Middle East? Then why did you set up the Hartigan hit to be blamed on Israel?
If it had blown over as the work of a fanatic, Israel would have been exonerated. You know how short the public memory is.
So I was the fall guy either way.
No. A soldier, sacrificed to a greater cause.
Who the hell do you think you are, Elliot? God?
with your army of killer robots? When I think of what we've done to earn your respect and your love, and all the while you were betraying us, who gave you the right to run the world? Damn you to hell!
Lower the gun! Now!
I will not tolerate violation of the Abelard sanction. Each of you will be under guard until there is a decision. Any violation, kill him.
Got a visitor.
What is this? Another setup?
Don't worry. They kill you, I kill them. You kill them, I kill you.
Your life is so simple.
Saul.
4 hours.
How did you get out?
Orla gave me his automatic and a way to escape. He said you're in here, even. I'm sure they've killed him. Are you all right?
Yes. I'm glad you're safe.
What's happened?
I can't get to Elliot in here. And now they're probably going to kick us out. Once outside, then he's mine.
You're obsessed with killing Elliot, aren't you? For God's sake, leave.
No. Not till it's over.
Sweetheart, listen to me. You and I have been cheated. We've been robbed of so much. Solly, please. Let's go. Leave it. Let's have a life, just you and me, a normal life.
No.
Oh, Solly, do you realize you'll be killing your father?
But he's not my father. Chris was the only family I ever had.
My God, you're letting him win.
The primary function of this retreat is to protect the clientele. Your presence here has jeopardized that protection. Therefore, your money will be refunded and you both shall leave. Elliot, because of your service over the years to this profession, you'll leave first. You'll have a day's head start that'll give you plenty of time to go far and hide deep. You leave in the morning. Romulus will remain 24 hours under guard. If you try to leave before then, you'll be shot. Good luck, gentlemen.
That's a long time, 24 hours. He could be on the far side of the moon by the time you get out of here.
You wouldn't be trying to goad me into doing something stupid, would you?
Oh, I'd love to trash you for all the trouble you've caused. For the next 24 hours, I am personally going to watch you every second. Just hoping.
All units. All units. Romulus is trying to escape. Terminate on sight.
No
Motor pool negative.
Chopper pad negative. We're starting a sweep.
By the time the pursuing guards reached the fence, Romulus was out of accurate range. As he was beyond the official border of the retreat, pursuit was not continued. End of report.
Has the chopper.
Where's Elliot?
Motel.
Where?
Up the road. A couple miles.
Where's Pollux?
With him.
out!
The minute I heard the chopper, I knew you'd won. Pollux?
Shot twice. Dead center. Dead center. Never saw a shot like it.
Well, you two are the only ones left. All the rest, dead.
I put it in the van.
May we go inside? I have something to say to you. Now, the critique. When we left this morning, I knew that you'd have to follow us immediately or you'd never find us. That meant either stealing a car or taking the chopper. Breaking out of the compound with a car is bad odds, so you took the chopper. Pollux and Castor dropped me off here, then they cruised around so that you'd spot them. But you won. In conditioning you and Chris, I was also conditioning myself. Absurd of me not to know that until Chris died. Ultimately, the conditioning failed you both. The system was based on a child's need for parental love. In the end, it was defeated by love. And Chris, love for God, you, and love for a woman, and in me and my love for my work. It's almost enough to make you believe in something. I apologize for tricking you, Romulus, but we had to get you inside to finish you. There's too much traffic out there. When he told me that Pollux was hit dead center, he was telling me that he was still alive. Pollux always wears his Kevlar vest when he's working. He should have made sure he was dead with a safety shot to the head. Sloppy, Romulus. You really are over the hill. I don't want to kill you, but I can't trust you. You might change your mind and come after me, and I still have my work to do. If it's any consolation, Sally, I love you.
Chris was cut in half by an Uzi.
Security tripled around my house. That maniac will be coming after me. He'll kill me if he gets a chance.
He walked away once. I know he'll come back.
Killing you is easy. But it doesn't make things even, Elliot. You took my brother from me. You corrupted everything I've done in my life and made everything I believe in worthless. And only God knows how many lives you've destroyed and manipulated with your dirty secret files. To lose them, that would be to lose everything, right? Well, it finally occurred to me where an obsessive maniac like you would hide those files. Sub Rosa. Under the roses, right? For the orphans, Elliot. For the orphans. Father.
In Washington today, John C. Elliott, senior deputy director of the CIA, resigned after 46 years of service. Elliott, a legend in the intelligence community, cited ill health as a reason for his sudden retirement.
018 nonstop to Tel Aviv is in the final boarding stage. All passengers should be on board.
Yes, this way. Champagne or orange juice?
Oh, no, thank you.
Hello.
I'm sorry, sir. You can't take those with you.
Why not?
Agricultural restrictions.
I never had much luck with roses.